St. Louis, Missouri has been at the crossroads of commerce and trade in the Mississippi Valley since 1764. But since the 1900s, it's been known as the home to world-class sports. St. Louis has hosted the 1904 Summer Olympics and has celebrated Super Bowl and World Series titles. But tonight, another sport comes to town for the first time. Up next, it's round six of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series from the Edward Jones Dome. Another great stadium truck event on tap tonight. I'm Brian Till, and joining me in the booth this evening, seven-time AMA motocross champion, Jeff Ward. Should also say a stadium super truck driver as well. Jeff, great to have you with me this weekend, but there are many fans out there that would rather see you still in the truck.
Well, it's great to be up here, but yeah, with all my motocross racing and a little bit of old age, I hurt my back at the San Diego race. Can't wait to get back out there and race with the guys, but I'm sure gonna enjoy being up here with you.
Well, it should be a fun evening. Always plenty of action in the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series. A lot of personality back in the paddock as well. And earlier, Kelly Stavis had a chance to catch up with one of the more popular drivers in the series.
Well, Ari Leyendijk Jr. had no off-road racing experience of any kind before Stadium Super Trucks, but he's been quietly going about his business and has found himself just outside of that lead group almost every race. Ari, you finished fourth three times. What do you need to do to take things up just to that next level and find yourself on the podium tonight?
I think that last race, I made one mistake during the race and Rob took advantage. And I think when you're in that crowd in the front, you just need to be mistake free for 20 laps. So for me, this track, it's been hard to adapt because it's been very fast. It's on a surface that's really tacky, so I'm not really used to it. But I'm gaining ground and hopefully I can be there in the end of the main. And I just got to break into that podium.
Ari will be racing the blue and teal number 25 truck, Brian.
Let's take a look at the format for this evening's entertainment. Always two heat races, a last chance qualifier, and then the main event, Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks from the Edward Jones Dome. So we'll take a look at how the event will unfold tonight. The top drivers will be split into two heats, top three in each heat, advance to the main event. Rest of the field has to go to the last chance qualifier. The winner of the main event, $40,000. The series champion, $500,000 in cash, a cool $500,000. Here's how they'll line up. Baumgartner on pole. Rob McCachran back in the back, and we're green and racing in St. Louis.
Well, this is gonna be a little bit difficult for them because they've kind of put some more jumps in the track since yesterday. So for the first time, they're gonna be hitting some obstacles they haven't hit.
And Lalo Laguna in the Visit Mexico truck, the red, white, and green truck. You saw him right there into Ari Leyendijk Jr. in that pale blue number 25. They're beating and banging already as Baumgartner leads up over the Tokyo crossover.
Yeah, Baumgartner's fun to watch. He's a sporadic driver that's never in the same place twice. So we got some hitting going on here, and it looks like Lopez has got by Laguna there, so which is good. This is his first time in the truck coming from the buggy.
Nick Baumgartner in the number 12, the white truck out in front, Pure Michigan on the side of it, as well as the American Red Cross leading right now. Baumgartner has been quick, you said it, Jeff, but he just needs to get a good finish. It always seems to slip away.
Well, you can see ADHD on his side of his truck there, and that we have a full course yellow right now. Well, Robbie Gordon's upside down.
Well, with Robbie Gordon's problems quickly cleaned up, we'll get back to green flag racing, and it doesn't take Baumgartner long in his number 12 to start to pull out, but Rob McCachran in that blue and silver Traxxas truck, the third in your shot, really making some hay, moving forward early.
Well, yeah, Rob started dead last, I believe, and that's you know, his trademark is to come from the back of the pack and be calm and get by these guys, and I'm assuming he's gonna be right up front here in no time.
And something new tonight called the Dash for Cash. They'll take the top four qualifiers that make it directly into the main event. In other words, you've got to finish in the top three of your heat race. The fastest four qualifiers that finish in the top three in their heat race, and they'll do a four-lap dash for $5,000. So right now, Robbie Gordon's missing out on it, but Rob McCachran has moved into one of those transfer spots. He's up to second, now chasing down Nick Baumgartner.
Yeah, Rob's got a ton of experience. He just knows where to put that truck in every corner, and he's, you know, talking to him earlier. He sets up two or three corners ahead to try to get by somebody. And Baumgartner's gonna have his hands full here right now.
Well, one thing that you guys talked about was the dirt tonight. It's clay, it's got good grip. Good grip is not necessarily what you want.
Well, Well, right now the track's nice and clean, but the longer the race goes on, there he is pushing his way right by it. I told you it wouldn't take any time for him to get by. But Baumgartner's not going to sit back and take this. He's a guy that likes to go after them.
Well, and you got to be impressed by McCacker trying to get to the front, and he risked a lot to get there, really pushing. But they said this track would lend itself to a lot of contact tonight, Jeff, the way it's laid out.
Well, yeah, because like this track is all dirt compared to we had some of the pavement, which is a little bit more one line. And so it's going to attend to a little more passing, and it's really wide, which is great.
Right now, Rob McCacker out front. Nick Baumgartner still holding on to second, Kelly.
Baumgartner, he hasn't really been able to put a great race together in its entirety. He told me that he's been really happy with the progress and the strides he's made from race to race. He says, I can't stop three quarters of the way through a race. I got to put a whole thing together. He thinks where he suffers is that lack of experience. He's still relatively new to off-road racing, and he said he finds himself in situations with the truck and doesn't know what to expect, whereas guys like Rob McCacker and Robbie Gordon know how to handle the truck when it gets a little sideways.
His best finish was fourth at the LA Coliseum. Other than that, been out of the top 10 in the last four. He had a sixth at Phoenix, so two finishes inside the top 10. But Kelly, you were right on. He just hasn't been able to put a consistent run together. And Jeff, you've driven these trucks. You know how difficult it is to be consistent. What's he need to do as a driver?
Well, every time he goes out there, he learns on what the truck's doing. When he lands sideways off a jump, which way the wheel's got to be, all the ruts and how it wants you to bicycle. And even Ari Leindach here, who started at the beginning of the year, was like a fish out of water. Now he's up, tied for fifth in the points. And the same with Baumgartner's got a little bit less, conservatism in him compared to Leindach being a road racer, letting it come slowly, where Baumgartner just hangs it out and makes bigger mistakes in the main events.
And with the grip this Clay has tonight, it could be Ari Leindach Jr., could be his best track, because he is a road racer, as you said. You saw a problem from the number five at Dally Lopez. But Leindach really coming to grips with these stadium super trucks. Three finishes in fourth, and then an 11th at LA, a 7th at Long Beach. And he's right there in the top five in the championship. You said it, he's really learning. He's really coming along and watching him on these track walks. Jeff, I think he's beginning to understand the racetrack themselves. You walked me around today. It's a completely different world than what I'm used to.
Yeah, I mean, it's and this dirt too, especially with this much grip, makes it even twice as hard as a track that's really slippery where you're driving with more of the rear of the car. This track, you're using a little more of the front, which is going to be totally different than what Ari's been used to this whole series. So he's just going to have to be a little patient and let it come to him. And right now he's doing a great job in qualifying position to get to the main event. But there's Rob McCacker here, and this shows you that how much work the driver's got to do. And this main of heat race is only 10 laps, so the 18 lap main event, they're going to be huffing and puffing.
Yeah, it is absolutely brutal. It's Rob McCacker leading, then Nick Baumgartner, followed by Ari Leindach Jr., then Lalo Laguna. Laguna trying to put a good run together. Abdali Lopez with a problem, still
a
stalled on the racetrack.
Yeah, front wheel.
Trucks are punished week in and week out.
I like Ari's truck there. It's got just his name on it, Ari. He's going by the one name already.
Look at McCacker over the Toyo crossover. He barely cleared it at that point in time.
Yeah, he's got a nice lead going now. He's just getting into a rhythm for the main event, probably trying some different lines, seeing how his truck works to make it better.
And you and I were talking about the ability to get across that Toyo crossover. Flying it is not the problem. What you don't want to do is go too far. Look at Lalo Laguna almost going too far into the side of Leindach, but over jumping can be almost as severe as under jumping.
Both of them hurt. So look at Rob's got a nice lead here, but the race for the qualifying position is back there with Ari and Lalo Laguna. So you want to make it to that main event. You got to go out there in that last chance. So Rob McCacker had an easy win right there.
Yeah, he takes the win. Baumgartner with a good run to second. And Ari Leindach continuing to show that he has learned his lesson. He finishes third. And that top three, they will transfer directly to the main event. Heat number one in the books from St. Louis. We'll be back to more Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks from the Edward Jones Dome.
Speed Energy Stadium. Stadium Super Trucks are coming to Chicago. Saturday night, June 22nd at Soldier Field, featuring urban off-road racing. Watch Bigfoot monster trucks fly into Soldier Field. Feel the horsepower of the Stadium Super Trucks under your feet as top drivers Robbie Gordon, Justin Lofton, and Rob McCracken battle for $40,000. Buy your seat for just $20. Kids 12 and under plus military personnel are $10 off. Tickets available at Ticketmaster.com or the Stadium box office. To see a complete race schedule, visit StadiumSuperTrucks.com.
Fastest name in radio control.
Every all-terrain tire claims to be tough, but when you have over 40% more tread life than the leading competitors, not to mention the longest warranty of any AT tire, the word tough just isn't tough enough.
With. He's a really awesome guy. Set up a great atmosphere here. We laugh, we joke, we have the best time. Except for when he sits in that chair.
I'm not even gonna look at you, Fritzy, because I know if I do, you'll start weeping. But you know what you're doing to me. You are ruining my life.
He sits, we split.
Boys.
The Dan Patrick Show, every weekday morning on the NBC Sports Network.
Friday, it's a full night of fighting. First, two elite power punchers. Undefeated heavyweight Brian Jennings. Light heavyweight sensation Sergey Kovalev. Oh, it's NBC Sports Network Fight Night. Then, step inside the cage as the most dangerous men in mixed martial arts square off in Las Vegas. It's the World Series of Fighting. Fitch versus Berkman. Friday at 11 on the NBC Sports Network.
Heat number one of round six of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series is in the books, and heat number two coming your way here shortly. Welcome back, everyone. Brian Till along with Jeff Ward. Jeff, great to have you here. We'd like to see you in a truck, but you can certainly give us some commentary and some advice. One of the things that I want to know is about this racetrack. This is the sixth round. The last four tracks, though, have had some hard pack on it, some type of asphalt or concrete. We're back to all dirt here in the sixth round. What's that going to do to these trucks? What's it going to do to the drivers?
Well, with the asphalt, you have a lot of predictability in each corner. So now that we have a track that has just all pavement, then now every corner has a rut in it. You have to be a little bit more on your toes. So it just makes it a lot more difficult for the drivers to get through each corner throughout the race.
Well, I think a lot more difficult maybe physically as well. You and I both talked to Robbie Gordon after qualifying. He said he was absolutely exhausted after just three or four laps. Think about the youth movement. Sheldon Creed, 15 years old. Keegan Kincaid, another youngster. Abdoli Lopez, only 18 years old. So you think about these guys. Are they going to have the endurance to get ahead of the more experienced drivers? I don't want to use the word older. Are they going to have the endurance to get there? Maybe take a checkered flag?
Well, yeah, the young guys are going to be able to, they might not think about it as much as the old guys. I mean, the old guys out there, like you said, are huffing and puffing. Maybe they're going to hold back at the beginning and save it for the end. And maybe the younger guys are going to burn themselves out early on. So we'll just have to see how it runs out here with the track.
Well, Jeff, you talked about experience. It is experience at the top of the charts. Robbie Gordon coming into this weekend, led by two over Rob McCracken. But with McCracken qualifying on the pole, he picks up another point. They're only 1 point apart right now.
Well, yeah, you kind of expect those two guys to be up there battling. But one I'm looking at is Ari Leindack Jr., who
came in with a road race background and was kind of a fish out of water at the first race in Phoenix. And he's been improving every week and moving up the ratings there.
Yeah, you look at the second page. There's Jeff Ward. You're 12th. You're not moving anywhere tonight.
Not tonight. But Sheldon Creed, who has been absolutely amazing and fast. And then maybe Lala Laguna, who's just had some bad luck. And I think that's why probably he's down there in points. I don't think he's had more bad luck than I have, but he's had some bad luck.
Well, the points continue to change with Rob McCracken winning heat number one. Heat number two, they'll line up like this. Justin Matney on the pole. Sheldon Creed qualified second. He'll start all the way back in sixth. That's what you get for doing well. You get inverted in the heat.
Yeah, it makes it exciting. He's an exciting young driver, so I expect him to go to the front.
Yeah, and here comes your excitement right now. The green flag flies. Standing start. Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series, and already Justin Matney beginning to pull out. But what we've seen from heat one, does it really matter? The hard chargers in the back, they're going to be pressing, and here they come over the tabletop for the first time.
Yeah, Creed's going to want to get up into the top three to make it right to the main event. The last chance is not really where you want to be for your starting position for the main, but it's the first time for these guys on the track since yesterday, and they put some more bumps in, so this first lap is they got to kind of tippy toe it around, not making any big mistakes right now.
Well, remember, you want to be in the top three to make that pass or directly to the main event. But don't forget the dash for cash. The fastest four qualifiers that do make it directly into the main event.
There's PJ taking the lead right there.
Look at that, PJ Jones to the front. Jones, another one of these drivers who have had some good runs. He sits well in the points. But he just hasn't been able to put it together for a win. He had a podium back in L.A. and a good run going here.
Yeah, PJ's been driving exceptionally well and just making some mistakes and being probably a little too aggressive on the track at the wrong times. But he's definitely come around. And, yeah, he's picked up his pace in every qualifying session. He's up there. And then even these heat races, he's been up there. It's been the main event that has been his downfall.
Yeah, aggressive is a word that goes well with PJ Jones. Aggressive in everything that he's ever driven. He's driven it well. He's tied for third right now with Justin Lofton in the points coming into this weekend. He's looking to pull away from him a little bit. He's pulling away from the rest of the pack. As you look back, Adrian Chinney now running second in that bright orange truck.
Here we are inside Lofton's truck. I'm surprised he's back there in the back as far. He's usually a lot more aggressive getting guys. Oh, but we have a problem here on the jump. So now we have to back up. This is one of the first I've seen this happen during the race.
Yeah, it's one of the problems. If you get hung up there, you can't get across that gap. Oh, wow.
Came up a little short.
Sheldon Creed came up a little short as he tried to get by. And this has allowed PJ Jones to really pull out.
Yeah, he's in a good position right now. What he's going to want to do now is just take it easy and learn for the main event, not make any mistakes, and just trying to clean up his corners. And he's got the position to do that because nobody's on him.
Got to be impressed with Keegan Kincaid running second. Just coming in your shot there. You look at Jones being pushed around. Kincaid running the 47 that we've seen Mike Jenkins in. The other Traxxas vehicle you'll see on track tonight. But right now, PJ Jones just really not pressured at all. And there's a look at Keegan Kincaid.
Yeah, another young driver that's learning as he goes. And to be in second place right now is just going to build his confidence. If he can finish up there and get to the main event right off the heat race, he's going to be a contender when the main event comes.
Yeah, he's having a great run for his first time in the series, Kelly.
Especially since this whole deal came together late. He just got the phone call on Tuesday to be out here in St. Louis. But Keegan is the son of Jeff Kincaid, a seven-time off-road racing champion. He said Keegan has already outdone his expectations. He's really just out here to have a great time, but I'm sure if he ends up on that podium, he'd take it.
Yeah, I would say he would, but you saw him really bicycling, Jeff. When you're in the truck, gets up on two wheels like that, how do you get it back down on all four?
Well, you got to turn into the slide and give a little throttle to bring it down. You don't want to let off or get on the brake. But if you can see right there, the ruts in this corner are just going to get bigger and bigger on every corner, so the drivers are going to have to be really aware when they back it in where those ruts are. And I expect a lot of bicycling tonight. But the track is tacky, so you're able to bring it back down. You're just losing a lot of time.
PJ Jones leading right now, but it was Rob McCracken who won the first event. Sure, he's plenty excited. Let's check in with Kelly Stavison, our winner of Heat 1.
Well, Rob McCaffrey wasted no time getting to the front of the field there in heat one. But Rob, it looked like when you pulled off that you were motioning to the crew that you've got an issue with the truck.
Yeah, once we got the lead there, when I was landing off the jumps and I was getting on the throttle, there was something in the back clunking really bad. So, you know, I thought in the qualifying, right at the end of qualifying, there was something vibrating just a little bit. And, you know, I think it's exposing itself now. So, you know, I wanted them guys to get back there as quick as they could and try to diagnose the problem, get it fixed so we can get back here for the main event tonight and hopefully put the tractor truck in the winner's circle again.
Thank you, Rob.
Well, they got to get that taken care of. PJ Jones needs to get a victory taken care of because Keegan Kincaid is really closing down on Jones.
Yeah, it's very surprising. I mean, Keegan must be getting used to the truck, or PJ's out there just being a little lackadaisical trying to pick some lines, and now he's going to have to fight for this win, which is really nice to see. I mean, he's being really aggressive, Kincaid, right now.
Adrian Chinney closing in as well. You look back a little bit, you see that bright orange number 10 beginning to close in, but got to be impressed with Keegan Kincaid. Now, the question is, if Chinney gets up to PJ Jones, if you're a fan of Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Racing, you'll know that at San Diego, round one, Chinney and PJ Jones got together and it turned into a fight back in the paddock. So not a lot of love lost between these two guys. Chinney really beginning to close down a little bit, but it's Keegan Kincaid still chewing on the back bumper of PJ Jones.
Yeah, they had a little altercation down there in San Diego, but you know, that's passion. I mean, they're out there, these guys are trying to win races, and when they feel that they've been undone in a corner, they express their feelings, and it was exciting to see him run across the track like that down there.
What, the white flag out, one lap to go, the youngster, the rookie to the series, Keegan Kincaid, really all over the back now. A little loose coming off the corner.
Yeah, a little mistake there, getting a little bit antsy, trying to gain some ground. But I'm pretty amazed at the pressure he's putting on, and you can see the confidence building already.
Well, we saw Sheldon Creed do the same thing to Robbie Gordon at the last round, San Diego number two. But Sheldon Creed having a bit of a problem right now. He's running well back, but it's PJ Jones with the lead, one corner left. Keegan's dropped back a little bit. PJ Jones, one left-hand corner to go, and then the Toyo crossover, the checkered flag waves. PJ Jones wins heat number two in St. Louis.
Well, that's a good confidence builder for PJ. I know he's won a heat race before this year. It's going to give him a good start on the main event. The main event, depending on what the draw is for the stagger.
Yeah, he's got to take those heat wins and turn them into a main event win. Checkered flag falls. PJ wants to see it at the main. We'll be back to more from St. Louis.
License and registration, please. Who do you think you are, Mario Andretti?
I'm Mario Andretti, officer. We weren't speeding.
I know the sound of speed when I hear it.
Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks are coming to Chicago Saturday night, June 22nd at Soldier Field, featuring urban off-road racing. Watch Bigfoot monster trucks fly into Soldier Field. Feel the horsepower of the Stadium Super Trucks under your feet as top drivers Robbie Gordon, Justin Lofton, and Rob McCaffrey battle for $40,000. Buy your seat for just $20. Kids 12 and under plus military personnel are $10 off. Tickets available at Ticketmaster.com or the Stadium box office. To see a complete race schedule, visit StadiumSuperTrucks.com.
Name in radio control.
Four Wheel Parts, the nation's largest truck and off-road accessories superstore, is celebrating over 50 years in business. We have everything you need, from tires and wheels to lift kits and off-road accessories. Call our staff of friendly experts toll-free at 855-295-JEEP. We can install anything we sell with over 56 stores nationwide. Call, walk in, or find us online at fourwheelparts.com. Four Wheel Parts, your truck and Jeep superstore.
Golf's best. Return to Marriott for America's national championship.
Expect anything different?
The U.S. Open.
begins Thursday at 3 Eastern on NBC.
This is the computer ICU. It's what happens to your computer when it gets infected, slows down, and crashes. And if you don't do something, your computer could wind up here in the computer graveyard. But it could be saved with mycleanpc.com.
Is your computer running slow? Are you frustrated with error messages, blue screens, computer freezes, and crashes? Then go to mycleanpc.com for your free diagnosis today. Then just activate the mycleanpc.com software to fix it in minutes. And computer specialists are available while you're online.
The best thing about mycleanpc.com was it had a free diagnosis.
My computer is 100% faster.
You know immediately what the problem is, and the problem is solved right then and there.
Download your free diagnosis today at mycleanpc.com.
Four Season Sunrooms, Windows and Additions introduces the stunning new 2013 Ligier Sunroom Edition. Incredibly energy efficient with a unique and elegant new design that will take sunroom living to a whole new level. And during our 2013 model introduction, you can still save up to 35% off the 2013 Hampton Room or Hybrid Rooms. Book your appointment online and get a $1,500 factory rebate and lock in your pricing that's guaranteed until 2014. Call Four Seasons now and save today.
Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks is brought to you by Procom, off-road driven. By Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Speed Energy, a healthier, faster choice of energy. Fuel the need.
And welcome back to the Edward Jones Dome in St. Louis, where P.J. Jones picked up his second heat race win of the season. P.J., we know this track just seems to change every session. Two heats in now. How was it out there?
Oh, it's great. You know, we got a local sponsor, Mittler Brothers Machine, and to have them here is awesome. But my truck's awesome. This is midget sprint car style, up on the cushion, standing the gas. I was cruising the first few laps. I saw, I don't know who was coming up behind me a little bit. And I thought, okay, last two laps, I'll stay on the gas, see what we got. But it's good. We're in the inversion, which is give us a good place to start in the main. And this place is awesome.
Congratulations to PJ Jones. Remember, if you finish at the top three in the first heats, you go straight to the final. Everybody else is right here, Jeff, the last chance qualifier.
Some heavy hitters here with Robbie Gordon and Sheldon Creed, two of the fastest guys in qualifying, had some problems in their heat race.
Well, and all through San Diego in the main event, Sheldon Creed, that young man right there in the white 74, chewed on the back bumper of Robbie Gordon, that man in the number 7, and the roles were reversed. Creed couldn't get anything done in the last chance qualifier today. Robbie Gordon couldn't get anything done.
Creed's a quick learner to get out front of Robbie and get some open track. And Robbie didn't let him get away, but a little mistake there. But Creed ran a great last chance qualifier. So these two are going to be back in the field a little bit, trying to come through the pack. Should be exciting.
Yeah, so he takes the checker flag. Great for him. But while this kind of helped set the field, still something else to do, the inversion. Kelly Stavis has more on that.
Brian, each of these Traxxas bodies is marked with a number 3 through 6, and that will determine how many cars are inverted for the starting grid for the main event. So lovely Taylor here from Traxxas is going to randomly pick one of these trucks to determine how many drivers will be inverted in the field. And it's a 5. The top 5 guys will be inverted in the main event.
So thanks, Kelly. With the top 5 inverted, this is the way they will roll off for the main event. Ari Lyandike Jr. starts from the pole. Keegan Kincaid on the front row as well. That young man's got to be excited.
It's a good place to start for your first race. Yeah. To be out front and have a little bit of room to make some mistakes and not get buried in the back.
Rob McCachran off in 5th. And you got to go back to 8th to find Robbie Gordon. He is our points leader. Sheldon Creed, a good starting position for him as well.
Yeah, they came from the last chance qualifier, so two of the fastest guys in qualifying are in the back, so that's expect them to move forward quick.
Yeah, it's going to get busy when the green flag falls. When we come back, though, just as we do every weekend, Super Trophy carts and Bigfoot monster trucks from right here in St. Louis, the Edward Jones Dome.
Every all-terrain tire claims to be tough. But when you have over 40% more tread life than the leading competitors, not to mention the longest warranty of any AT tire, the word tough just isn't tough enough.
Feeling sluggish, old, and tired? It could be because your body is dehydrated on a cellular level. Most purified waters are acidic and as a result may be rejected by your body. But it doesn't have to be that way. Real water is different. It is beyond alkalinity. Real water is infused with negative ions for ultra-cellular hydration. You will immediately notice the smooth, clean taste as you start hydrating the minute it hits your mouth. Real water. You will taste and feel this difference.
License and registration, please. Who do you think you are, Mario Andretti?
I'm Mario Andretti, officer. We weren't speeding.
I know the sound of speed when I hear it.
For MLS, all season long on NBC and the NBC Sports Network.
Boston, Chicago, two original six teams from two proud cities. Wednesday night in primetime, only the toughest who claim the NHL's top prize. Kane and Taze, Bergeron and Rask. Bruins, Blackhawks, Game 1 of the Stanley Cup Final. Wednesday, live 8, 7 Central, only on NBC. Because it's the Cup.
A look across the Mississippi River at the St. Louis skyline. The arch there that's so famous here in St. Louis. It's round 6 of Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks from the Edward Jones Dome. And don't forget, it's not just Stadium Super Trucks on the weekend. Also, Super Trophy carts running here. A lot of time, just 9 to 16-year-olds run them. But this weekend, it was adults as well. Didn't take long for the problems to start.
Somebody going over there. These carts are a little bit bigger than the trophy carts for the smaller kids, so you can put the full-size grown-ups in, and they're fun to drive.
Problems around the racetrack, but not for the 74. If you think that number sounds familiar and you've been watching the Stadium Super Truck races lately, it would, because it is familiar. It's Sheldon Creed in the 74. Another cart with a problem, but not for Sheldon Creed.
Well, he grew up driving these type of trucks, so he's definitely familiar with them and has kind of an unfair advantage out there, but he can drive anything fast and good.
DJ Noor, very familiar with the trophy carts, but Sheldon Creed just put on a clinic and takes the victory. Impressive stuff.
Yeah, I've watched him in the trucks and these cars, and the kid's got tons of confidence and always puts it in the right place.
Yeah, he does pretty good donuts, too.
Sure, it's not his first one.
Sheldon Creed, DJ Noor, Matt Baker, that's the top three in trophy carts. Monster trucks, here's the runoff for third, and these things are always impressive. Lone Star, David Smith behind the wheel, Speed Energy, Bigfoot, Larry Swim, they go wheel to wheel. Swim takes third, and then you got to go to the final. It's Dan Runty and Bigfoot, Darren Basil and Digital Effects Graffiti. And it's the first time we've seen Basil in his truck. Runty, very familiar, actually holds the world record for the longest jump. Had a good run going here, makes a little mistake. And Basil takes the victory, and then he celebrates.
Yep, didn't go quite as planned.
The race worked out, but not so much this, Jeff.
He's trying to get out of the stadium here, I think. It's, Not how he wanted to celebrate his victory, but victory nonetheless.
No, he climbs up on the truck. He gets to celebrate. He goes, yeah, well, no. And so that didn't work out so well. So Darren Basil takes the win. Dan Runte has to settle for second place. No one wants to settle for second in the Stadium Super Truck Final. The main event coming up from the Edward Jones Dome right after this. Stay with us.
Super Trucks are coming to Chicago Saturday night, June 22nd at Soldier Field, featuring urban off-road racing. Watch Bigfoot monster trucks fly into Soldier Field. Feel the horsepower of the Stadium Super Trucks under your feet as top drivers Robbie Gordon, Justin Lofton, and Rob McCracken battle for $40,000. Buy your seat for just $20. Kids 12 and under plus military personnel are $10 off. Tickets available at Ticketmaster.com or the Stadium box office. To see a complete race schedule, visit StadiumSuperTrucks.com.
Name in radio control.
Four Wheel Parts, the nation's largest truck and off-road accessories superstore, is celebrating over 50 years in business. We have everything you need, from tires and wheels to lift kits and off-road accessories. Call our staff of friendly experts toll-free at 855-295-JEEP. We can install anything we sell with over 56 stores nationwide. Call, walk in, or find us online at fourwheelparts.com. Four Wheel Parts, your truck and Jeep superstore.
Trucks beginning to roll out for the main event from here at Edwards Jones Dome. You see Ari Leyendijk Jr., he'll start from the pole. Everybody getting ready for the excitement of 18 laps here. And a bit earlier, Kelly Stavis caught up with one of the new kids on the block. That's a pretty good starting position for the main.
Well, Keegan Kincaid will be starting from the front row in his Stadium Super Truck debut. And Keegan, you told me earlier today, before you had done any racing, that you had already exceeded expectations. But now that you have this killer starting spot after the inversion, what are your expectations?
I'm just going to say it's the same game plan. I'm going to go out there, you know, give it my all, push to the front right away, and hopefully stay there. You know, gap the rest of the field, because I know Robbie and Sheldon and all those, and Rob Mack are going to be coming hard. So
best of luck. Thank you, Keegan.
Thank you very much.
Well, Keegan Kincaid certainly will have a good view from his second starting position. This is how they'll line up. Remember, the top five were inverted, so Ari Leyendijk Jr. starts from the pole.
Yeah, it's a great position. He started there a couple times this year and hasn't been able to stay up front because of his inexperience in the series. And now that he's got some confidence, I expect him to run up front for quite a while.
PJ Jones won a heat race. He'll start fourth. The question is, when can he win a main event? Rob McCracken only 1 point behind Robbie Gordon right now in the championship, rolls off in fifth. Who's not in the top six? Robbie Gordon, and he's gonna have to really close down at the drop of the green. I don't expect that he's gonna lag back, Jeff, but I mean, this championship, it's tight.
Well, it's 18 laps, so basically you want to get through this first half of the race without making any major mistakes. And like you said, you got the faster guys starting the back. Even Creed's back there, he won in the last chance race. So they're gonna be pushing these front guys that don't quite have the speed as the other guys had in these last races. So that's what makes it exciting.
You said exciting, and it's about to get exciting. Green flag's going to wave here. Standing start for the final round six of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series. It is underway. Ari Leyendijk Jr. leads from the front row, and it's already getting busy behind him.
Yeah, it's pretty important you get to these first few corners without getting banged up and hit or knocked off the track and then settle in. So Ari looks like he's doing a great job up front right now.
Got a little bit of breathing room, but not a lot. Keegan Kincaid, so impressive. His first run in the Stadium Super Truck Series, and he has been very impressive, and he's already trying to make an impression on Ari Leyendijk Jr. Running in third there in the white number 12, Nick Baumgartner.
And then McCracken is already right behind him, so he's moved up a couple spots already. I know he wants to get out front and get that clear track, but the guys up front here are running really good.
Rob McCracken already pushing forward, Kelly.
Try on him because Rob McCracken had problems with his truck. He heard that clunky noise that he talked about after the heat race. Well, they never could get to the bottom of the issue, but they did change his tranny because they suspected expected that could be at the root of the problem, but he said he wouldn't really know till he got out here on track. And if he does have a problem, he'll be nursing at home to get as many points as he can.
Interesting. He said there was a clunking in the back. I wouldn't think that was the transmission, Jeff, but they changed it. So really, Rob McCaughrey has an unknown. What is known? He's pressing hard right now.
Yeah, it doesn't seem to be bothering him right now, but yeah, lucky that happened in the heat race and not in the main event for the point. So he's putting some good pressure on here on Bob Gardner, and the track's going to just get more and more difficult as we get going.
Talk about pressure. Keegan Kincaid has taken over the lead as you ride on board with Rob McCaughrey. Ari Leyendijk Jr. has been shuffled back, and you ride on board with McCaughrey trying to get past the number 12 of Nick Baumgartner. McCaughrey currently being shown in third. He's moving forward, but he's going to have to get past the snowboard cross champion.
And he's going to force it right here.
Yep. Baumgartner not making it easy. Oh, and they rub a little bit.
Yeah, McCaughrey, he's so smooth when you watch him on the in-car camera. He just does nothing really quick, just takes it nice and easy, and then just sticks it right in there like he did. He wants to get out front and get the lead.
See him shifting gears there. The transmission, a three-speed transmission. Typically, right. How many gears are you using around a track like this?
They'll be only using first and second. He's also got the cutting brake, which is up there on the top right, to get the back end to rotate. It puts more brake bias to the rear. With a track tacky like this, you don't use it as much, but that's what gets these things rotated and gets them pointed straight.
Well, it's kind of like the parking brake in your car, but like you said, with the track as sticky as it is, guys have said they may not use it very much now. Rob McCaughrey really beginning to put pressure on Keegan Kincaid.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how Keegan handles the pressure with Rob Mack behind him, because that guy's relentless and just he's there the whole time.
Well, got a problem on the racetrack. The red has come out, truck upside down.
There we go.
It's Justin Lofton.
He's been having a tough night. It seems like everything he's been in has been upside down or just not going his way.
Let's take a look. Justin Lofton's going to get some help from Robbie Gordon.
That's a tough one for Robbie for the points. He's lost his hood. He has to come in the pits to get a hood put back on and may get penalized for rough driving.
So they've gotten Lofton back on four wheels, but it was a pretty vicious hit. And one of the things about this racetrack, it's wide, and some of the drivers were concerned it's going to invite that inside move. Take a look.
Yeah, it looked like Robbie just kind of jumped into that jump, got a little far in there, couldn't get stopped, and then Lofton was cutting down on the inside. It's pretty unfortunate.
Right front to Lofton's left rear, and it sends him over. And if you're a fan of Stadium Super Trucks, you'll notice there are no option lanes this weekend. And the track, that's what we said, the beauty about the series, it's always different. What we mean by option lanes at some of the other racetracks, there were two different choices you could make when you got to a certain corner. The inside lane may be shorter, but it had sand in it. The outside lane might have been longer, but it had some differences as well. And you had a choice of what you could do. Here, there is no option lane. The only option, go green, and they're back at it.
Looks like Kincaid's putting some good pressure maybe up front, and then Robbie's Rob McCaughrey's right on him right now, so he's got the pressure again of McCaughrey behind him.
McCaughrey right behind him, then Nick Baumgartner, then Sheldon Creed running fourth. Kelly?
Well, you might notice that a purple ribbon and the word Grammy on the side of Sheldon Creed's truck. He's got a whole bunch of family that's from the St. Louis area in attendance tonight. Among them, his grandma, he calls Grammy. That purple ribbon, though, is to recognize that she was diagnosed with stomach cancer earlier this year. Good news is the cancer is shrinking. She is among the family members here, but Sheldon Creed has got a lot of support here in St. Louis.
Man, he should have a lot of support. They're cheering, guaranteed. It is getting wild. Creed up to second, up to the lead right now.
This kid is good.
Impressive stuff.
He's fearless. He's not afraid to put the truck anywhere. He's not afraid to put his foot on the pedal. So these guys behind him now have their work cut out of them to keep up with him.
Yeah, he crawled back in a trophy cart, won that event, and now out in front. Remember last round, the pressure he put on Robbie Gordon, the final going, couldn't get it done. But right now, smooth sailing and a great run. You ride on board right now with Robbie Gordon.
Well, Robbie, I think, is in a good position right now. I mean, he's back there a ways. He's getting beat up a little bit, but he's going to start pushing his way back up to the front.
The last restart was wild. Gordon now being shown in seventh. He's got to move forward.
Oh, we have Creed looking like he went off the track.
Sheldon Creed with a problem, no longer in the lead. It elevates Rob Mack to the front. Creed with a problem coming through the Toyo crossover. Had to take an escape road, and he has moved well back. And also a problem with a stalled truck on track. I believe it may be PJ Jones.
Yeah, we got a lot of banging going on out right there, but the Rob Mack's out front where he likes to be. Right, Kate in second, and Baumgartner's hanging in third real well.
It's where he needs to be because Robbie Gordon's still back in the pack a bit. And this is going to be a big points night, perhaps.
Here comes Robbie. Robbie's got to get by some guys here. We got a long way to go, but he needs to get up there with Rob Mack for this championship.
McCachran, then Keegan Kincaid being shown second, then Nick Baumgartner being shown third. It's some intense battles going on right now. That's the number five, Abdali Lopez.
We have a yellow on the track.
So full course caution here from round six. Things have heated up big time. There are parts everywhere. We'll get the field gathered up. We'll get it sorted out. We'll be back to more from St. Louis. Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks.
Every all-terrain tire claims to be tough. But when you have over 40% more tread life than the leading competitors, not to mention the longest warranty of any AT tire, the word tough just isn't tough enough.
Are you feeling sluggish, old, and tired? It could be because your body is dehydrated on a cellular level. Most purified waters are acidic and as a result may be rejected by your body. But it doesn't have to be that way. Real water is different. It is beyond alkalinity. Real water is infused with negative ions for ultra-cellular hydration. You will immediately notice the smooth, clean taste as you start hydrating the minute it hits your mouth. Real water. You will taste and feel this difference.
In 2 weeks, it's Stadium Off-Road Racing taken to the extreme. Don't miss the first race of this exciting new series, poised to test the limits of racing. Robbie Gordon's Stadium Super Truck Series continues in 2 weeks on NBC.
People love. Now that's progressive. Call or click today.
With my iComfort mattress, I wake up and I'm ready to take on the world.
I love this bed because the minute that I lay down in it, I find that sweet spot and I am asleep immediately.
Now is the time to update to the iComfort sleep system by Serta. Featuring the first memory foam infused with our micro support gel.
It supports my back, it supports my joints, it gives me the rest that I need.
Call now to receive your free info kit and discover how iComfort's cool action material can provide enhanced cooling comfort and extra support.
The iComfort keeps us comfortable all night long.
Some mornings I just don't want to get out of bed.
Call now to receive special 0% financing for up to 18 months. Update to the iComfort sleep system by Serta. Smarter, cooler, better. Learn more about our 0% financing on iComfort. Call 1-888-243-3004 or visit iComfort.com now.
Now the green flies. We're back in St. Louis in round six, the main event of Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks back underway. Rob McCachran leads the field to the green, and it has been an absolute wild one to this point.
Yeah, we're just at halfway right now, and here's Robbie Gordon. coming back up into third place. Knew it wouldn't take long for him to get up there. And now he's setting his sights on Rob Mack. He needs those points.
He's been part of the wildest, we should say.
Well, that's Robbie Gordon's MO, is that wildness. So we're keeping an eye on him. He's bound to get right up there in second, and we're going to have a shootout for the points championship.
Oh, and a problem there. Damage to the front end of Adrian Cheney's truck. We'll go back under full course caution while they get Cheney out of the way. So Cheney able to pull his truck out of the way, which is good news. Just limps it around the corner, and the field will be gathered back up. And Rob Mack leads the field back, expecting to see the green. And at the Toyo crossover, it does wave. Here we go again. Keegan Kincaid right behind him. And then the very hard charging Robbie Gordon back there as well. You notice the hood gone off of Gordon's car. Several of them have that way. In past races, you had to come in and replace it. But with as many of them that are missing tonight, I'm not sure that they've got the parts to get it done.
And I think, it would hurt the racing. I mean, they have to kind of make a call there on that. And I think with the way they're driving right now, the way the track's lending itself to some hard passing and hard hitting, they have to let it go.
Talk about passing and hard hitting. Keegan Kincaid really putting the pressure on, as is Robbie Gordon there in third. It is tight up front, really. In fact, it's tight all throughout the field, as you can see a little further back in that shot. And Rob Mack digging, doing everything he can to try to pull out, regain that points lead.
Well, I think this is what they were hoping the track would be like, leaving it without the option lanes where guys having to make different moves. It looks like Cheney may have just pulled off there. Kincaid just pulled off the track.
Oh yeah, Keegan Kincaid with a problem. Had a great run in second. Now he has dropped out with a problem. That has elevated Robbie Gordon to the back bumper of Rob Mack.
Yeah, now we have the two. We got the points leader chasing the guy that's right behind him. So there's Robbie's going to put the hammer down to try to get him back.
That is not what Rob McCracken wanted to see, but he's going to have a mirror full of an Orange Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck here shortly. Well, the board's beginning to claw down on him.
These two guys have been running fast all year long, so there's no surprise that Rob Mack's out front, Robbie's in second. But I don't expect it. Rob's going to have an easy time here keeping Robbie behind him.
And last lap by
here
Gordon,
we go. Look,
was a little bit faster.
It. Here we are, side by side. Robbie's got the inside and makes the move.
Gets it done. The question is, can he hold on to it? Who set their truck up to deal with these changing track conditions? I mean, Jeff, the track has changed considerably since the first heat.
Yeah, I don't know if you can. I mean, right now you're looking at, you can see that glossy part of the dirt is not dirt. It's actually the concrete that's underneath. So they have no idea how their trucks work on that and how big the ruts get. So it's experience here right now, like we talked about earlier with the younger kids and the older guys, and the two out front have the most experience.
Right now they're making the best of it. Sheldon Creed in the 74 trying to work his way back up after the problem that he had over the Toyo crossover. So far, still well back. He's in fifth. He'd like to move forward. You see Rob McCracken fly over, and that's the thing that's so impressive.
And here we
Speaking
go.
Of over.
Oh, Creed's upside down.
Sheldon Creed had a great day going, then it got bad. Now it just got worse. So Sheldon Creed goes turtle, so they've got to get him back over on all fours, and that allows the field to get sorted out. And here's what happens.
Yeah, he just caught. There's a inside little lip there that he caught with the inside front wheel.
You talk about the dirt being pushed out of the way, and you can see it right there. It creates a big berm. They hit that berm. If you're not ready for it and you don't have the truck set, it's going to go over. The two guys who have been able to deal with it all night long, we talked about it earlier, experience. And you got experience out in front right now.
You can see them putting the back wheels right up against the cushion. They're not letting it slide in and hit hard. They're bringing it in really soft and sensitive, and they're the best at this game, and that's what it's still a challenge for both those guys leading right now.
Yeah, we talked about youth attacking, and the youth has had a problem with that.
We got
experience out front,
here,
but yeah,
third place. So that's an awesome run for him this year. He hasn't been on the podium, and we got about four more laps to go, and he may get his first podium here tonight.
He's got to hold on to it, but he has some youth behind him. Abdali Lopez, who recently won his class in the Baja 500, won the last two Super Buggy events at SST races. He's doing a great job
for his first time out here. These trucks are not easy to drive, and this track looks to be one of the most difficult that we have.
Oh, it may be difficult, but Rob Mack made the best of it. He's gotten back past Gordon.
This is what the fans came to see here, this racing, and these last two laps are gonna, Robbie is not gonna let this one get away.
Oh, it has gotten intense up front, and Rob Mack goes back past Gordon. Championship implications here. This is the sixth round. We're halfway through. These guys beginning to distance themselves in the championship from the rest of the field, but they are staying close. Gordon with a bicycle.
Yeah, this track is extremely difficult. What I'm really impressed about is Baumgartner. He's hanging tough right there in third, right behind Robbie. And oh, Robbie almost went off the same place Creed did.
Gordon with a big problem. That's allowing Baumgartner to really close in, fighting the ruts. Gordon fighting his truck right now.
Well, this is exactly what Rob Mack wants to see, is Robbie off the back a little bit, where he can be a little bit more precise with the ruts and not hanging out. Now you're going to see Robbie really let it loose here.
He's got no other choice if he wants to hold on to his championship. So he slipped back a little bit. Nick Baumgartner now having to deal with Abdali Lopez right behind him in the five. Lalo Laguna in there as well.
Yeah, these guys are handling this track very well. A lot of veterans have made some problems, but and we got McCaffrey trying to get through the lapper here. That was good. He got all the way.
That was good. That was Keegan Kincaid who had come in and got his truck back underway. But Rob McCaffrey really pulling out. The white flag is out. Robbie Gordon slipping back. Can Nick Baumgartner improve? Right now he's got a podium position, his first of the season. But can he get past Gordon? He's running out of time. Rob Mack is in one corner to go. The checkered flag flies. Rob McCaffrey takes another victory. He wins at St. Louis.
Wow, that's impressive. That guy knows how to drive. Knows how to drive everything. But I think Robbie, once he got away, just kind of brought it home a second to keep it close.
Awesome stuff. Rob McCaffrey becomes the first three-time winner of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series. We'll be back for more with our winner right after this from St. Louis.
See?
You know I see it. I seen it before you did it.
You come on, man. You know I saw that before you even said anything.
Say what?
Tell me what you see.
You already know what I'm seeing.
So you see what I'm saying, right?
I saw it. I'm seeing it right now. I'm looking right at it.
Right. Get
this. Oh, yeah. Right there.
The new bottle? What's there to say?
The new Miller Lite bottle. Find one at a bar near you.
Head and Shoulders and Old Spice are now together in one bottle.
So we're always 100% flake-free.
While smelling 100% handsome.
And with a double dose of confidence like that.
Good happens.
Head and Shoulders with Old Spice.
This Father's Day, give Craftsman tools and give Dad the ability to make even more. From everyday projects to the ones that last a lifetime. Give the latest in Craftsman tools and make more than just his day. Craftsman, made to make.
Listen, your storyline, it makes for incredible TV drama. Thing is, your drug use is too adult for the kids. So I'm gonna have to block you.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Well, have a good one.
You're a nice lady.
Formula One drivers. Action, reaction. Man plus machine. Life at the speed of F1. Formula One. New season, new home. On the NBC Sports Network.
In 2 weeks, it's Stadium Off-Road Racing taken to the extreme. Don't miss the first race of this exciting new series, poised to test the limits of racing. Robbie Gordon's Stadium Super Truck Series continues in 2 weeks on NBC.
This is the NBC Sports Network.
Well, the checkered flag has fallen on round six of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series. Exciting as always, and Kelly Stavis is winner.
Well, the first question out of Rob McCaffrey's mouth was, did Robbie still finish second? Because that's who you're battling for this championship, Rob. But kind of came all down to that final restart.
Yeah, you know, it did. You know, this track, it was a great track. But as you can see, it really came apart. And the ruts got big. And it was a battle out there trying to stay smooth, trying to keep the truck in the ruts and make everything go forward. But, you know, I can't thank Traxxas enough. You know, they got these little RC cars that are funner than heck to drive. And this little SST truck is great to drive, too. And, you know, Robbie, what a battle. You know, it was tough. We had to just be patient, be careful. He got by me there, tried to pressure him, bicycle before that finish line corner. And then I didn't think he had enough speed to make the double there. And when I landed, I looked in my mirror and he made it. So from then on, we just wanted to, you know, play it smooth and get to the finish line.
Well, Rob McCracken certainly has plenty to celebrate. Win number three on the season, but we talked about experience, Jeff. Experience wins out.
Yeah, tonight it definitely did. We had some fast younger drivers out there that had their problems, but Rob Mack ended up back on top again, and Robbie Gordon came from a long ways back to get second.
But you talk about McCracken being on top again, on top of the points again as well, unofficially, 22 points.
Well, that was his plan. He came in a couple points behind and wanted to win the race and take the points lead back over, and he accomplished his goal. So,
yeah. A big points haul for sure from here in St. Louis. Round six is down. Round seven from Soldier Field in Chicago on the 22nd. You'll see it on NBC on the 23rd. For Jeff Ward, Kelly Stavast, I'm Brian Till. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.
Second at Soldier Field, featuring urban off-road racing. Watch Bigfoot monster trucks fly into Soldier Field. Feel the horsepower of the stadium super trucks under your feet as top drivers Robbie Gordon, Justin Lofton, and Rob McCracken battle for $40,000. Buy your seat for just $20. Kids 12 and under plus military personnel are $10 off. Tickets available at Ticketmaster.com or the stadium box office. To see a complete race schedule, visit StadiumSuperTrucks.com.
Name in radio control.
Every all-terrain tire claims to be tough, but when you have over 40% more tread life than the leading competitors, not to mention the longest warranty of any AT tire, the word tough just isn't tough enough.
With. He's a really awesome guy. Set up a great atmosphere here. We laugh, we joke, we have the best time. Except for when he sits in that chair.
I'm not even gonna look at you, Fritzy, because I know if I do, you'll start weeping. But you know what you're doing to me. You are ruining my life.
He sits, we split.
Boys.
The Dan Patrick Show, every weekday morning on the NBC Sports Network.
Friday, it's a full night of fighting. First, two elite power punchers. Undefeated heavyweight Brian Jennings. Light heavyweight sensation Sergey Kovalev. Oh, it's NBC Sports Network Fight Night. Then, step inside the cage as the most dangerous men in mixed martial arts square off in Las Vegas. It's the World Series of Fighting. Fitch versus Berkman. Friday at 11 on the NBC Sports Network.
Number one of round six of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series is in the books, and heat number two coming your way here shortly. Welcome back, everyone. Brian Till along with Jeff Ward. Jeff, great to have you here. We'd like to see you in a truck, but you can certainly give us some commentary and some advice. One of the things that I want to know is about this racetrack. This is the sixth round. The last four tracks, though, have had some hard pack on it, some type of asphalt or concrete. We're back to all dirt here in the sixth round. What's that going to do to these trucks? What's it going to do to the drivers?
Well, with the asphalt, you have a lot of predictability in each corner. So now that we have a track that has just all pavement,
then now every corner has a rut in it. You have to be a little bit more on your toes. So it just makes it a lot more difficult for the drivers to get through each corner throughout the race.
Well, I think a lot more difficult maybe physically as well. You and I both talked to Robbie Gordon after qualifying. He said he was absolutely exhausted after just three or four laps. Think about the youth movement. Sheldon Creed, 15 years old. Keegan Kincaid, another youngster. Abdoli Lopez, only 18 years old. So you think about these guys, are they going to have the endurance to get ahead of the more experienced drivers? I don't want to use the word older. Are they going to have the endurance to get there? Maybe take a checkered flag?
Well, yeah, the young guys are going to be able to, they might not think about it as much as the old guys. I mean, the old guys out there, like you said, are huffing and puffing. Maybe they're going to hold back at the beginning and save it for the end. And maybe the younger guys are going to burn themselves out early on. So we'll just have to see how it runs out here with the track.
Well, Jeff, you talked about experience. It is experience at the top of the charts. Robbie Gordon coming into this weekend, led by two over Rob McCracken. But with McCracken qualifying on the pole, he picks up another point. They're only 1 point apart right now.
Well, yeah, you kind of expect those two guys to be up there battling. But one I'm looking at is Ari Lindack Jr., who came in with a road race background and was kind of a fish out of water at the first race in Phoenix. And he's been improving every week and moving up the ratings there.
Yeah, you look at the second page. There's Jeff Ward. You're 12. You're not moving anywhere tonight.
Not tonight. But Sheldon Creed, who has been absolutely amazing and fast. And then maybe Lala Laguna, who's just had some bad luck. And I think that's why probably he's down there in points. I don't think he's had more bad luck than I have, but he's had some bad luck.
Well, the points continue to change with Rob McCracken winning heat number one. Heat number two, they'll line up like this. Justin Matney on the pole. Sheldon Creed qualified second. He'll start all the way back in sixth. That's what you get for doing well. You get inverted in the heat.
Yeah, it makes it exciting. He's an exciting young driver, so I expect him to go to the front.
Yeah, and here comes your excitement right now. The green flag flies. Standing start. Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series, and already Justin Matney beginning to pull out. But what we've seen from heat one, does it really matter? The hard chargers in the back, they're going to be pressing, and here they come over the tabletop for the first time.
Yeah, Creed's going to want to get up into the top three to make it right to the main event. The last chance is not really where you want to be for your starting position for the main, but it's the first time for these guys on the track since yesterday, and they put some more bumps in. So this first lap is they got to kind of tippy toe it around, not make any big mistakes right now.
Well, remember, you want to be in the top three to make that pass or directly to the main event. But don't forget the dash for cash. The fastest four qualifiers that do make it directly into the main event.
There's PJ taking the lead right there.
Look at that, PJ Jones to the front. Jones, another one of these drivers who have had some good runs. He sits well in the points. But he just hasn't been able to put it together for a win. He had a podium back in L.A. and a good run going here.
Yeah, PJ's been driving exceptionally well and just making some mistakes and being probably a little too aggressive on the track at the wrong times. But he's definitely come around. And, yeah, he's picked up his pace in every qualifying session. He's up there. And then even these heat races, he's been up there. It's been the main event that has been his downfall.
Yeah, aggressive. It's a word that goes well with PJ Jones. Aggressive in everything that he's ever driven. He's driven it well. He's tied for third right now with Justin Lofton in the points coming into this weekend. He's looking to pull away from him a little bit. He's pulling away from the rest of the pack. As you look back, Adrian Chinney now running second in that bright orange truck.
Here we are inside Lofton's truck. I'm surprised he's back there in the back as far. He's usually a lot more aggressive getting guys. Oh, but we have a problem here on the jump. So now we have to back up. This is one of the first I've seen this happen during the race.
Yeah, it's one of the problems. If you get hung up there, you can't get across that gap. Oh, wow.
Came up a little short.
Sheldon Creed came up a little short as he tried to get by. And this has allowed PJ Jones to really pull out.
Yeah, he's in a good position right now. What he's going to want to do now is just take it easy and learn for the main event, not make any mistakes, and just trying to clean up his corners. And he's got the position to do that because nobody's on him.
Got to be impressed with Keegan Kincaid running second. Just coming in your shot there. You look at Jones being pushed around. Kincaid running the 47 that we've seen Mike Jenkins in. The other Traxxas vehicle you'll see on track tonight. But right now, PJ Jones just really not pressured at all. And there's a look at Keegan Kincaid.
Yeah, another young driver that's learning as he goes. And to be in second place right now is just going to build his confidence. If he can finish up there and get to the main event right off the heat race, he's going to be a contender when the main event comes.
Yeah, he's having a great run for his first time in the series, Kelly.
Especially since this whole deal came together late. He just got the phone call on Tuesday to be out here in St. Louis. But Keegan is the son of Jeff Kincaid, a seven-time off-road racing champion. He said Keegan has already outdone his expectations. He's really just out here to have a great time, but I'm sure if he ends up on that podium, he'd take it.
Yeah, I would say he would, but you saw him really bicycling, Jeff. When you're in the truck, he gets up on two wheels like that. How do you get it back down on all four?
Well, you got to turn into the slide and give a little throttle to bring it down. You don't want to let off or get on the brake. But if you can see right there, the ruts in this corner are just going to get bigger and bigger on every corner. So the drivers are going to have to be really aware when they back it in where those ruts are. And I expect a lot of bicycling tonight. But the track is tacky, so you're able to bring it back down. You're just losing a lot of time.
DJ Jones leading right now, but it was Rob McCachran who won the first event. Sure, he's plenty excited. Let's check in with Kelly Stavison, our winner of Heat 1.
Well, Rob McCachran wasted no time getting to the front of the field there in Heat 1, but Rob, it looked like when you pulled off that you were motioning to the crew that you've got an issue with the truck.
Yeah, once we got the lead there when I was landing off the jump.
Claims to be tough, but when you have over 40% more tread life than the leading competitors, not to mention the longest warranty of any AT tire, the word tough just isn't tough enough.
Are you feeling sluggish, old, and tired? It could be because your body is dehydrated on a cellular level. Most purified waters are acidic and as a result may be rejected by your body. But it doesn't have to be that way. Real water is different. It is beyond alkalinity. Real water is infused with negative ions for ultra-cellular hydration. You will immediately notice the smooth, clean taste as you start hydrating the minute it hits your mouth. Real water. You will taste and feel this difference.
License and registration, please. Who do you think you are, Mario Andretti?
I'm Mario Andretti, officer. We weren't speeding.
I know the sound of speed when I hear it.
For MLS all season long on NBC and the NBC Sports Network.
Boston, Chicago, two original six teams from two proud cities. Wednesday night in primetime, only the toughest will claim the NHL's top prize. Kane and Taze, Bergeron and Rask. Bruins, Blackhawks, Game 1 of the Stanley Cup Final. Wednesday, live 8, 7 Central, only on NBC. Because it's the Cup.
A look across the Mississippi River at the St. Louis skyline. The arch there that's so famous here in St. Louis. It's round 6 of Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks from the Edward Jones Dome. And don't forget, it's not just Stadium Super Trucks on the weekend. Also, Super Trophy carts running here. A lot of time, just 9 to 16-year-olds run them. But this weekend, it was adults as well. Didn't take long for the problems to start.
Somebody going over there. These carts are a little bit bigger than the trophy carts for the smaller kids, so you can put the full-size grown-ups in, and they're fun to drive.
Problems around the racetrack, but not for the 74. If you think that number sounds familiar and you've been watching the Stadium Super Truck races lately, it would, because it is familiar. It's Sheldon Creed in the 74. Another cart with a problem, but not for Sheldon Creed.
Well, he grew up driving these type of trucks, so he's definitely familiar with them and has kind of an unfair advantage out there, but he can drive anything fast and good.
DJ Noor, very familiar with the trophy carts, but Sheldon Creed just put on a clinic and takes the victory. Impressive stuff.
Yeah, I've watched him in the trucks and these cars, and the kid's got tons of confidence and always puts it in the right place.
Yeah, he does pretty good donuts, too.
Sure, it's not his first ones.
Sheldon Creed, DJ Norm, Matt Baker, that's the top three in trophy carts. Monster trucks, here's the runoff for third. And these things are always impressive. Lone Star, David Smith behind the wheel. Speed Energy, Bigfoot, Larry Swim. They go wheel to wheel. Swim takes third, and then you got to go to the final. It's Dan Runty and Bigfoot, Darren Basil and Digital Effects Graffiti. And it's the first time we've seen Basil in his truck. Runty, very familiar, actually holds the world record for the longest jump. Had a good run going here, makes a little mistake. Basil takes the victory, and then he celebrates.
Nope, didn't go quite as planned.
The race worked out, but not so much this, Jeff.
He's trying to get out of the stadium here, I think. It's not how he wanted to celebrate his victory, but a victory nonetheless.
No, he climbs up on the truck. He gets to celebrate. He goes, yeah, well, no. So that didn't work out so well. So Darren Basil takes the win. Dan Runty has to settle for second place. No one wants to settle for second in the Stadium Super Truck Final, the main event coming up from the Edward Jones Dome right after this. Stay with us.
Super Trucks are coming to Chicago Saturday night, June 22nd at Soldier Field, featuring urban off-road racing. Watch Bigfoot monster trucks fly into Soldier Field. Feel the horsepower of the Stadium Super Trucks under your feet as top drivers Robbie Gordon, Justin Lofton, and Rob McCracken battle for $40,000. Buy your seat for just $20. Kids 12 and under plus military personnel are $10 off. Tickets available at Ticketmaster.com or the Stadium box office. To see a complete race schedule, visit StadiumSuperTrucks.com.
Name in radio control.
Four Wheel Parts, the nation's largest truck and off-road accessories superstore, is celebrating over 50 years in business. We have everything you need, from tires and wheels to lift kits and off-road accessories. Call our staff of friendly experts toll free at 855-295-JEEP. We can install anything we sell with over 56 stores nationwide. Call, walk in, or find us online at fourwheelparts.com. Four Wheel Parts, your truck and Jeep superstore.
Trucks beginning to roll out for the main event from here at Edwards Jones Dome. You see Ari Leyendijk Jr., he'll start from the pole. Everybody getting ready for the excitement of 18 laps here. And a bit earlier, Kelly Stavis caught up with one of the new kids on the block. That's a pretty good starting position for the main.
Well, Keegan Kincaid will be starting from the front row in his Stadium Super Truck debut. And Keegan, you told me earlier today, before you had done any racing, that you had already exceeded expectations. But now that you have this killer starting spot after the inversion, what are your expectations?
I'm just going to say it's the same game plan. I'm going to go out there, give it my all, push to the front right away, and hopefully stay there. Gap the rest of the field, because I know Robbie and Sheldon and all those, and Rob Mack are going to be coming hard. So
best of luck. Thank you, Keegan.
Thank you very much.
Well, Keegan Kincaid certainly will have a good view from his second starting position. This is how they'll line up. Remember, the top five were inverted, so Ari Leyendijk Jr. starts from the pole.
Yeah, it's a great position. He started there a couple times this year and hasn't been able to stay up front because of his inexperience in the series. And now that he's got some confidence, I expect him to run up front for quite a while.
PJ Jones won a heat race. He'll start fourth. The question is, when can he win a main event? Rob McCracken only 1 point behind Robbie Gordon right now in the championship, rolls off in fifth. Who's not in the top six? Robbie Gordon, and he's gonna have to really close down at the drop of the green. I don't expect that he's gonna lag back, Jeff, but I mean, this championship, it's tight.
Well, it's 18 laps, so basically you wanna get through this first half of the race without making any major mistakes. And like you said, you got the faster guys starting the back, even Creed's back there, he won the last chance race. So they're gonna be pushing these front guys that don't quite have the speed as the other guys had in these last races. So that's what makes it exciting.
You said exciting, and it's about to get exciting. Green flag's going to wave here. Standing start for the final round six of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series. It is underway. Ari Lyon-Dyke Jr. leads from the front row, and it's already getting busy behind him.
Yeah, it's pretty important to get to these first few corners without getting banged up and hit or knocked off the track and then settle in. So Ari looks like he's doing a great job up front right now.
He's got a little bit of breathing room, but not a lot. Keegan Kincaid, so impressive. His first run in the Stadium Super Truck Series, and he has been very impressive, and he's already trying to make an impression on Ari Lyon-Dyke Jr. Running in third there in the white number 12, Nick Baumgartner.
And then McCachran is already right behind him, so he's moved up a couple spots already. I know he wants to get out front and get that clear track, but the guys up front here run.
So I was getting on the throttle. There was something in the back clunking really bad. So, you know, I thought in the qualifying, right at the end of qualifying, there was something vibrating just a little bit. And, you know, I think it's exposing itself now. So, you know, I wanted them guys to get back there as quick as they could and try to diagnose the problem, get it fixed. We can get back here for the main event tonight and hopefully put the Tractor truck in the winner's circle again.
Thank you, Rob.
Well, they got to get that taken care of. PJ Jones needs to get a victory taken care of because Keegan Kincaid is really closing down on Jones.
Yeah, it's very surprising. I mean, Keegan must be getting used to the truck, or PJ's out there just being a little lackadaisical trying to pick some lines, and now he's going to have to fight for this win, which is really nice to see. I mean, he's being really aggressive, Kincaid, right now.
Adrian Chinney closing in as well. You look back a little bit, you see that bright orange number 10 beginning to close in, but got to be impressed with Keegan Kincaid. Now, the question is, if Chinney gets up to PJ Jones, if you're a fan of Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Racing, you'll know that at San Diego, round one, Chinney and PJ Jones got together and it turned into a fight back in the paddock. So not a lot of love lost between these two guys. Chinney really beginning to close down a little bit, but it's Keegan Kincaid still chewing on the back bumper of PJ Jones.
Yeah, they had a little altercation down there in San Diego, but you know, that's passion. I mean, they're out there, these guys are trying to win races, and when they feel that they've been undone in a corner, they express their feelings, and it was exciting to see him run across the track like that down there.
One white flag out, one lap to go. The youngster, the rookie to the series, Keegan Kincaid, really all over the back now. A little loose coming off the corner.
Yeah, a little mistake there, getting a little bit antsy, trying to gain some ground. But I'm pretty amazed at the pressure he's putting on, and you can see the confidence building already.
Well, we saw Sheldon Creed do the same thing to Robbie Gordon at the last round, San Diego number two. But Sheldon Creed having a bit of a problem right now. He's running well back, but it's PJ Jones with the lead, one corner left. Keegan's dropped back a little bit. PJ Jones, one left-hand corner to go, and then the Toyo crossover, the checkered flag waves. PJ Jones wins heat number two in St. Louis.
Well, that's a good confidence builder for PJ. I know he's won a heat race before this year. It's going to give him a good start on the main event. The main event, depending on what the draw is for the stagger.
Yeah, he's got to take those heat wins and turn them into a main event win. Checkered flag falls. PJ wants to see it at the main. We'll be back to more from St. Louis.
License and registration, please. Who do you think you are, Mario Andretti?
I'm Mario Andretti, officer. We weren't speeding.
I know the sound of speed when I hear it.
Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks are coming to Chicago Saturday night, June 22nd at Soldier Field, featuring urban off-road racing. Watch Bigfoot monster trucks fly into Soldier Field. Feel the horsepower of the Stadium Super Trucks under your feet as top drivers Robbie Gordon, Justin Lofton, and Rob McCachran battle for $40,000. Buy your seat for just $20. Kids 12 and under plus military personnel are $10 off. Tickets available at Ticketmaster.com or the Stadium box office. To see a complete race schedule, visit StadiumSuperTrucks.com.
Name in radio control. 4Wheel Parts, the nation's largest truck and off-road accessories superstore, is celebrating over 50 years in business. We have everything you need, from tires and wheels to lift kits and off-road accessories. Call our staff of friendly experts toll-free at 855-295-JEEP. We can install anything we sell with over 56 stores nationwide. Call, walk in, or find us online at 4WheelParts.com. 4Wheel Parts, your truck and Jeep superstore.
Golf's best. We turn to Marion for America's National Championship.
Expect anything different?
The U.S. Open begins Thursday at 3 Eastern on NBC.
This is the computer ICU. It's what happens to your computer when it gets infected, slows down, and crashes. And if you don't do something, your computer could wind up here in the computer graveyard. But it could be saved with mycleanpc.com.
Is your computer running slow? Are you frustrated with error messages, blue screens, computer freezes, and crashes? Then go to mycleanpc.com for your free diagnosis today. Then just activate the mycleanpc.com software to fix it in minutes. And computer specialists are available while you're online.
The best thing about mycleanpc.com was it had a free diagnosis.
My computer is 100% faster.
You know immediately what the problem is, and the problem is solved right then and there.
Download your free diagnosis today at mycleanpc.com.
Four Season Sunrooms, Windows and Additions introduces the stunning new 2013 Ligier Sunroom Edition. Incredibly energy efficient with a unique and elegant new design that will take sunroom living to a whole new level. And during our 2013 model introduction, you can still save up to 35% off the 2013 Hampton Room or Hybrid Rooms. Book your appointment online and get a $1,500 factory rebate and lock in your pricing that's guaranteed until 2014. Call Four Seasons now and save today.
Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks is brought to you by Procom, off-road driven. By Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Speed Energy, a healthier, faster choice of energy. Fuel the need.
And welcome back to the Edward Jones Dome in St. Louis, where P.J. Jones picked up his second heat race win of the season. P.J., we know this track just seems to change every session. Two heats in now. How was it out there?
Oh, it's great. You know, we got a local sponsor, Mittler Brothers Machine, and to have them here is awesome. But my truck's awesome. This is midget sprint car style, up on the cushion, standing the gas. I was cruising the first few laps. I saw, I don't know who was, come up behind me a little bit. And I thought, okay, last two laps, I'll stay on the gas, see what we got. But it's good. We're in the inversion, which is give us a good place to start in the main. And this place is awesome.
Congratulations to PJ Jones. Remember, if you finish at the top three in the first heats, you go straight to the final. Everybody else is right here, Jeff, the last chance qualifier.
Some heavy hitters there with Robbie Gordon and Sheldon Creed. Two of the fastest guys in qualifying had some problems in their heat race.
Well, and all through San Diego in the main event, Sheldon Creed, that young man right there in the white 74, chewed on the back bumper of Robbie Gordon, that man in the number 7, and the roles were reversed. Creed couldn't get anything done in the last chance qualifier today. Robbie Gordon couldn't get anything done.
Creed's a quick learner to get out front of Robbie and get some open track. And Robbie didn't let him get away, but a little mistake there. But Creed ran a great last chance qualifier. So these two are going to be back in the field a little bit, trying to come through the pack. Should be exciting.
Yeah, so he takes the checker flag. Great for him. But while this kind of helped set the field, still something else to do, the inversion. Kelly Stavis has more on that.
Brian, each of these Traxxas bodies is marked with a number 3 through 6, and that will determine how many cars are inverted for the starting grid for the main event. So lovely Taylor here from Traxxas is going to randomly pick one of these trucks to determine how many drivers will be inverted in the field. And it's a 5. The top 5 guys will be inverted in the main event.
So thanks, Kelly. With the top 5 inverted, this is the way they will roll off for the main event. Ari Lyandike Jr. starts from the pole. Keegan Kincaid on the front row as well. That young man's got to be excited.
It's good place to start for your first race. Yeah. To be out front and have a little bit of room to make some mistakes and not get buried in the back.
Rob McCachran off in fifth, and you got to go back to eighth to find Robbie Gordon. He is our points leader. Sheldon Creed, a good starting position for him as well.
Yeah, they came from the last chance qualifier, so two of the, one of the fastest guys in qualifying are in the back, so that's, expect them to move forward quick.
Yeah, it's going to get busy when the green flag falls. When we come back, though, just as we do every weekend, Super Trophy carts and Bigfoot monster trucks from right here in St. Louis, the Edward Jones Dome.
Every all-terrain tire.
Been really good.
Rob McCachran already pushing forward, Kelly.
Rely on him because Rob McCachran had problems with his truck. He heard that clunky noise that he talked about after the heat race. Well, they never could get to the bottom of the issue, but they did change his tranny because they suspected that could be at the root of the problem, but he said he wouldn't really know until he got out here on track. And if he does have a problem, he'll be nursing at home to get as many points as he can.
Interesting. He said there was a clunking in the back. I wouldn't think that was the transmission, Jeff, but they changed it. So really, Rob McCachran has an unknown. What is known? He's pressing hard right now.
Yeah, it doesn't seem to be bothering him right now, but yeah, lucky that happened in the heat race and not in the main event for the points. So he's putting some good pressure on here on Bob Gardner, and the track's going to just get more and more difficult as we get going.
Talk about pressure. Keegan Kincaid has taken over the lead as you ride on board with Rob McCachran. Ari Leyendyk Jr. has been shuffled back, and you ride on board with McCachran trying to get past the number 12 of Nick Baumgartner. McCachran currently being shown in third. He's moving forward, but he's going to have to get past the snowboard cross champion.
And he's going to force it right here.
Yep. Baumgartner not making it easy. Oh, and they rub a little bit.
Yeah, McCachran, he's so smooth when you watch him on the in-car camera. He just does nothing really quick, just takes it nice and easy, and then just sticks it right in there like he did. He wants to get out front and get the lead.
See him shifting gears there. The transmission, a three-speed transmission. Typically, right. How many gears are you using around a track like this?
They'll be only using first and second. He's also got the cutting brake, which is up there on the top right, to get the back end to rotate. It puts more brake bias to the rear. With a track tacky like this, you don't use it as much, but that's what gets these things rotated and gets them pointed straight.
Well, it's kind of like the parking brake in your car, but like you said, with the track as sticky as it is, guys have said they may not use it very much now. Rob McCachran really beginning to put pressure on Keegan Kincaid.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how Keegan handles the pressure with Rob Mack behind him, because that guy's relentless and just he's there the whole time.
Well, got a problem on the racetrack. The red has come out, truck upside down.
There we go.
It's Justin Lofton.
He's been having a tough night. It seems like everything he's been in has been upside down or just not going his way.
Let's take a look. Justin Lofton's going to get some help from Robbie Gordon.
That's a tough one for Robbie for the points. He's lost his hood. He has to come in the pits to get a hood put back on and may get penalized for rough driving.
So they've gotten Lofton back on four wheels, but it was a pretty vicious hit. And one of the things about this racetrack, it's wide, and some of the drivers were concerned it's going to invite that inside move. Take a look.
Yeah, it looked like Robbie just kind of jumped into that jump, got a little far in there, couldn't get stopped, and then Lofton was cutting down on the inside. It's pretty unfortunate.
Right front to Lofton's left rear, and it sends him over. And if you're a fan of Stadium Super Trucks, you'll notice there are no option lanes this weekend. And the track, that's what we said, the beauty about the series, it's always different. What we mean by option lanes at some of the other racetracks, there were two different choices you could make when you got to a certain corner. The inside lane may be shorter, but it had sand in it. The outside lane might have been longer, but it had some differences as well. And you had a choice of what you could do. Here, there is no option lane. The only option, go green, and they're back at it.
Looks like Kincaid's putting some good pressure maybe up front, and then Robbie's Rob McCachran's right on him right now, so he's got the pressure again of McCachran behind him.
McCachran right behind him, then Nick Baumgartner, then Sheldon Creed running fourth. Kelly?
Well, you might notice that a purple ribbon and the word Grammy on the side of Sheldon Creed's truck. He's got a whole bunch of family that's from the St. Louis area in attendance tonight. Among them, his grandma, he calls Grammy. That purple ribbon, though, is to recognize that she was diagnosed with stomach cancer earlier this year. Good news is the cancer is is shrinking. She is among the family members here, but Sheldon Creed has got a lot of support here in St. Louis.
Man, he should have a lot of support. They're cheering, guaranteed. It is getting wild. Creed up to second, up to the lead right now.
This kid is good.
Impressive stuff.
He's fearless. He's not afraid to put the truck anywhere. He's not afraid to put his foot on the pedal. So these guys behind him now have their work cut out of them to keep up with him.
Yeah, he crawled back in a trophy cart, won that event, and now out in front. Remember last round, the pressure he put on Robbie Gordon in the final going. Couldn't get it done, but right now, smooth sailing and a great run. You're right on board right now with Robbie Gordon.
Well, Robbie, I think, is in a good position right now. I mean, he's back there a ways. He's getting beat up a little bit, but he's going to start pushing his way back up to the front.
Last restart was wild. Gordon now being shown in seventh. He's got to move forward.
Oh, we have Creed looking like he went off the track.
Sheldon Creed with a problem. No longer in the lead. It elevates Rob Mack to the front. Creed with a problem coming through the Toyo crossover. Had to take an escape road, and he has moved well back. And also a problem with a stalled truck on track. I believe it may be PJ Jones.
Yeah, we got a lot of banging going on out right there, but Rob Mack's out front where he likes to be. Kincaid in second, and Baumgartner's hanging in third real well.
It's where he needs to be because Robbie Gordon's still back in the pack a bit. And this is going to be a big points night, perhaps.
Here comes Robbie. Robbie's got to get by some guys here. We got a long way to go, but he needs to get up there with Rob Mack for this championship.
McCachran, then Keegan Kincaid being shown second, then Nick Baumgartner being shown third. And some intense battles going on right now. That's the number five, Abdali Lopez.
We have a yellow on the track.
So full course caution here. Round six, things have heated up big time. There are parts everywhere. We'll get the field gathered up. We'll get it sorted out. We'll be back to more from St. Louis. Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks.
Every all-terrain tire claims to be tough, but when you have over 40% more tread life than the leading competitors, not to mention the longest warranty of any AT tire, the word tough just isn't tough enough.
Are you feeling sluggish, old, and tired? It could be because your body is dehydrated on a cellular level. Most purified waters are acidic, and as a result, may be rejected by your body. But it doesn't have to be that way. Real water is different. It is beyond alkalinity. Real water is infused with negative ions for ultra-cellular hydration. You will immediately notice the smooth, clean taste as you start hydrating the minute it hits your mouth. Real water. You will taste and feel this difference.
In 2 weeks, it's Stadium Off-Road Racing taken to the extreme. Don't miss the first race of this exciting new series, poised to test the limits of racing. Robbie Gordon's Stadium Super Truck Series continues in 2 weeks on NBC.
People love. Now that's progressive. Call or click today.
With my iComfort mattress, I wake up and I'm ready to take on the world.
I love this bed because the minute that I lay down in it, I find that sweet spot and I am asleep immediately.
Now is the time to update.
to the iComfort Sleep System by Serta. Featuring the first memory foam infused with our micro-support gel.
It supports my back, it supports my joints, it gives me the rest that I need.
Call now to receive your free info kit and discover how iComfort's cool action material can provide enhanced cooling comfort and extra support.
The iComfort keeps us comfortable all night long.
Some mornings I just don't want to get out of bed.
Call now to receive special 0% financing for up to...
St. Louis, Missouri has been at the crossroads of commerce and trade in the Mississippi Valley since 1764. But since the 1900s, it's been known as the home to world-class sports. St. Louis has hosted the 1904 Summer Olympics and has celebrated Super Bowl and World Series titles. But tonight, another sport comes to town for the first time. Up next, it's round six of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series from the Edward Jones Dome. Another great stadium truck event on tap tonight. I'm Brian Till, and joining me in the booth this evening, seven-time AMA motocross champion Jeff Ward. Should also say a stadium super truck driver as well. Jeff, great to have you with me this weekend, but there are many fans out there that would rather see you still in the truck.
Well, it's great to be up here, but yeah, with all my motocross racing and a little bit of old age, I hurt my back at the San Diego race. Can't wait to get back out there and race with the guys, but I'm sure going to enjoy being up here with you.
Well, it should be a fun evening. Always plenty of action in the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck Series. A lot of personality back in the paddock as well. And earlier, Kelly Stavis had a chance to catch up with one of the more popular drivers in the series.
Well, Ari Leyendijk Jr. had no off-road racing experience of any kind before Stadium Super Trucks, but he's been quietly going about his business and has found himself just outside of that lead group almost every race. Ari, you finished fourth three times. What do you need to do to take things up just to that next level and find yourself on the podium tonight?
I think that last race, I made one mistake during the race and Rob took advantage. And I think when you're in that crowd in the front, you just need to be mistake free for 20 laps. So for me, this track, it's been hard to adapt because it's been very fast. It's on a surface that's really tacky, so I'm not really used to it. But I'm gaining ground and hopefully I can be there in the end of the main. And I just got to break into that podium.
Ari will be racing the blue and teal number 25 truck. Brian.
Let's take a look at the format for this evening's entertainment. Always two heat races, a last chance qualifier, and then the main event. Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks from the Edward Jones Dome. So we'll take a look at how the event will unfold tonight. The top drivers will be split into two heats, top three in each heat, advance to the main event. Rest of the field has to go to the last chance qualifier. The winner of the main event, $40,000. The series champion, $500,000 in cash, a cool $500,000. Here's how they'll line up. Baumgartner on pole. Rob McCachran back in the back, and we're green and racing in St. Louis.
Well, this is going to be a little bit difficult for them because they've kind of put some more jumps in the track since yesterday. So for the first time, they're going to be hitting some obstacles they haven't hit.
And Lalo Laguna in the Visit Mexico truck, the red, white, and green truck. You saw him right there into Ari Leyendijk Jr. in that pale blue number 25. They're beating and banging already as Baumgartner leads up over the Tokyo crossover.
Yeah, Baumgartner's fun to watch. He's a sporadic driver that's never in the same place twice. So we got some hitting going on here, and it looks like Lopez has got by Laguna there, so which is good. This is his first time in the truck coming from the buggy.
Nick Baumgartner in the number 12, the white truck out in front. Pure Michigan on the side of it, as well as the American Red Cross leading right now. Baumgartner has been quick. You said it, Jeff, but he just needs to get a good finish. It always seems to slip away.
Well, you can see ADHD on his side of his truck there, and that we have a full course yellow right now. Well, Robbie Gordon's upside down.
Well, with Robbie Gordon's problems quickly cleaned up, we'll get back to green flag racing, and it doesn't take Baumgartner long in his number 12 to start to pull out, but Rob McCachran in that blue and silver Traxxas truck, the third in your shot, really making some hay, moving forward early.
Well, yeah, Rob started dead last, I believe, and that's his trademark is to come from the back of the pack and be calm and get by these guys, and I assume he's going to be right up front here in no time.
It's something new tonight called the Dash for Cash. They'll take the top four qualifiers that make it directly into the main event. In other words, you've got to finish in the top three of your heat race. The fastest four qualifiers that finish in the top three in their heat race
they'll do a four-lap dash for $5,000. So right now, Robbie Gordon's missing out on it, but Rob McCachran has moved into one of those transfer spots. He's up to second, now chasing down Nick Baumgartner.
Yeah, Rob's got a ton of experience. He just knows where to put that truck in every corner, and he's, you know, talking to him earlier, he sets up two or three corners ahead to try to get by somebody. And Baumgartner's going to have his hands full here right now.
Well, one thing that you guys talked about was the dirt tonight. It's clay. It's got good grip. Good grip is not necessarily what you want.
Well, right now the track's nice and clean, but the longer the race goes on, there he is pushing his way right by it. I told you it wouldn't take any time for him to get by. But Baumgartner's not going to sit back and take this. He's the guy that likes to go after them.
Well, and you got to be impressed by McCachran trying to get to the front, and he risked a lot to get there, really pushing. But they said this track would lend itself to a lot of contact tonight, Jeff, the way it's laid out.
Well, yeah, because like this track is all dirt compared to we had some of the pavement, which is a little bit more one line. And so it's going to attend to a little more passing, and it's really wide, which is great.
Right now, Rob McCachran out front. Nick Baumgartner still holding on to second, Kelly.
Baumgartner, he hasn't really been able to put a great race together in its entirety. He told me that he's been really happy with the progress and the strides he's made from race to race. He says, I can't stop three quarters of the way through a race. I got to put a whole thing together. He thinks where he suffers is that lack of experience. He's still relatively new to off-road racing, and he said he finds himself in situations with the truck and doesn't know what to expect, whereas guys like Rob McCachran and Robbie Gordon know how to handle the truck when it gets a little sideways.
His best finish was fourth at the LA Coliseum. Other than that, been out of the top 10 in the last four. He had a sixth at Phoenix, so two finishes inside the top 10. But Kelly, you were right on. He just hasn't been able to put a consistent run together. And Jeff, you've driven these trucks. You know how difficult it is to be consistent. What's he need to do as a driver?
Well, every time he goes out there, he learns on what the truck's doing. When he lands sideways off a jump, which way the wheel's got to be, all the ruts of how it wants you to bicycle. And even Ari Leindach here, who started at the beginning of the year, was like a fish out of water. Now he's up, tied for fifth in the points. And the same with Baumgartner's got a little bit less, conservatism in him compared to Leindach being a road racer, letting it come slowly, where Baumgartner just hangs it out and makes bigger mistakes in the main events.
And with the grip this clay has tonight, it could be Ari Leindach Jr., could be his best track, because he is a road racer, as you said. You saw a problem from the number five at Dally Lopez. But Leindach really coming to grips with these stadium super trucks. Three finishes in fourth, and then an 11th at LA, a 7th at Long Beach. And he's right there in the top five in the championship. You said it, he's really learning. He's really coming along, and watching him on these track walks. Jeff, I think he's beginning to understand the racetrack themselves. You walked me around today. It's a completely different world than what I'm used to.
Yeah, I mean, it's and this dirt too, especially with this much grip, makes it even twice as hard as a track that's really slippery, where you're driving with more of the rear of the car. This track, you're using a little more of the front, which is going to be totally different than what Ari's been used to this whole series. So he's just going to have to be a little patient and let it come to him. And right now he's doing a great job in qualifying position to get to the main event. But there's Rob McCachran here, and this shows you that how much work the driver's got to do. And this main of heat race is only 10 laps, so the 18-lap main event, they're going to be huffing and puffing.
Yeah, it is absolutely brutal. It's Rob McCachran leading, then Nick Baumgartner, followed by Ari Leindach Jr., then Lalo Laguna. Laguna trying to put a good run together. Abdali Lopez with a problem, still stalled on the racetrack.
Yeah, front wheel.
Trucks are punished week in and week out.
I like Ari's truck there. It's got just his name on it, Ari. He's going by the one name already.
Look at McCachran over the Toyo crossover. He barely cleared it at that point in time.
Yeah, he's got a nice lead going now. He's just getting into a rhythm for the main event, probably trying some different lines, seeing how his truck works to make it better.
And you and I were talking about the ability to get across that Toyo crossover. Flying it is not the problem. What you don't want to do is go too far. Look at Lalo Laguna almost going too far into the side of Leindach, but over jumping can be almost as severe as under jumping.
Both of them hurt. So look at Rob's got a nice lead here, but the race for the qualifying position is back there with Ari and Lalo Laguna. So you want to make it to that main event. You got to go out there in that last chance. So Rob McCachran had an easy win right there.
Yeah, he takes the win. Baumgartner with a good run to second. And And Ari Leyendyke continuing to show that he has learned his lesson. He finishes third, and that top three, they will transfer directly to the main event. Heat number one in the books from St. Louis. We'll be back to more Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks from the Edward Jones Dome.